Hi there, I'm Bart van den Burg, and I'm here to tell you about the RRM, which is a library I wrote. What is the RRM? The RRM is a problem solver. It helps me save a lot of time debugging code, especially when it comes to throwing events all around. I'm going to show you that in this example. We have a controller, a directive, and another directive, and they're all talking to the same basket manager. For example, the controller does something to the basket, gets a new version of that basket, and then it has to tell all the other parts of the code that the basket is updated so that they can do their logic with it. So you have some events, listeners. Well, then another directive does another operation on the basket, and you have the same sequence again, and another directive does something on the basket as well. I don't really like that. Before you know it, your whole code is full of events, and it just becomes really difficult to debug. So what I wanted to do is go back to a situation like this where there's no events at all. And for that, I built the RRM. Sorry. What you do is whenever you have an update in your basket manager on your basket, you first pass the new basket to the RRM, then get it back, and you're automatically done, because all the controller directives, they all have the same instance of that basket, which is updated. So any watchers that were in the controllers or in the views or whatever, they're automatically called already. This slide, my boss, who's not here today, he's going to kick my ass about it. He specifically told me, Bart, don't add code to your slides. And I deleted all the slides. And then today I added this slide. John, I'm sorry. You're going to see this later. So this is kind of how it works. For example, you got a project from your API, and you want to store it in your RRM. The OM is an instance of the RRM. You say it's a project, and the ID is one, and there's a couple of products in it. In this case, only one. The ID of the product is five, but there could be more properties on it. This is assuming that you have set up the RRM correctly, of course. Then this code becomes possible. You can get the project out of the RRM by the ID, and then get the product by the ID, and then you can assert that the first product on the project is, in fact, the exact same instance. So this line of code alerts a true. This also does the same. You don't have to have the products in line. You can also create them manually later on. And it doesn't even matter in what order you do it. So for the same code, this also alerts true. And you can even do something like this. The first product of the project is linked back to the same project again, and you can see that it is, in fact, the same project. So the RRM is a young library. The reason I'm here telling you about it is because I want to motivate you people not only to use it, but to contribute on it. I could really use your guys' help. So if anyone is interested, come find me for discussion. Tonight, tomorrow, I'll be at the hackathon as well. You can find me on Twitter. I have a really ugly contact form on my website as well. And below is the URL to the repository. That's it. Thanks.